take a picture of you.
Yeah.
It's not real.
If we could talk to the animals, just imagine it, chatting with a chimp and chimpanzee. Imagine talking to a tiger, chatting with a cheetah. What a neat achievement it would be. If we could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree. We'd study elephant and eagle, buffalo and beagle, alligator, guinea pig and flea. We could converse in polar bear and python, and we could curse in fluent kangaroo. If people ask us, can you speak rhinoceros? We'd say, of carceros, can you? If we conferred with our furry friends, man to animal, think of all the things we could discuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us. If we consulted with quadrupeds, think what fun we'd have asking over crocodiles for tea. Or maybe lunch with two or three lions, walruses or sea lions. What a lovely place the world would be. We'd learn to speak in antelope and turtle. Our Pekingese would be extremely good. If we were asked to sing in hippopotamus, we'd say winotamus and would. And I am sure every octopus, lobster and platypus certainly would see it as a plus. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us. We'd study every living creature's language so we could speak to all of them on sight. If you said, can you talk in clam or pelican? And I'd be right. If we all spoke like animals, who needs English? Gradually we'd drop it with no fuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could squeak and squawk and speak and talk to us. If we could talk to the animals, just imagine it, chatting with a chimp and chimpanzee. Imagine talking to a tiger, chatting with a cheetah. What a neat achievement it would be. If we could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree. We'd study elephant and eagle, buffalo and beagle, alligator, guinea pig and flea. We could converse in polar bear and python, and we could curse in fluent kangaroo. If people ask us, can you speak rhinoceros? We'd say, of carceros, can you? If we conferred with our furry friends, man to animal, think of all the things we could discuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us. If we consulted with quadrupeds, think what fun we'd have asking over crocodiles for tea. Or maybe lunch with two or three lions, walruses or sea lions. What a lovely place the world would be. We'd learn to speak in antelope and turtle. Our Pekingese would be extremely good. If we were asked to sing in hippopotamus, we'd say winotamus and would. And I am sure every octopus, lobster and platypus certainly would see it as a plus. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us. We'd study every living creature's language so we could speak to all of them on sight. If you said, can you talk in clam or pelican? And I'd be right. If we all spoke like animals, who needs English? Gradually we'd drop it with no fuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could squeak and squawk and speak and talk to us.